Number 8. Tom Hutchinson. 52-year-old businessman Tom Hutchinson lost his life in a devastating kitesurfing accident at a popular holiday beach in the Isle of Wight. Hutchinson, who reportedly ran a successful sailing business, was experienced in kitesurfing. He owned a home in the Isle of Wight, and in the summer of 2019, Hutchinson and his family went there on holiday. Hutchinson was out on the water when a violent wind current took him over 150 feet into the air. The man was then slammed into a rock face, twice at high speed. He suffered critical head injuries. Hutchinson was airlifted to a hospital where he later passed away, surrounded by his family. Kite surfing, also known as kite boarding, is an extreme sport that combines elements from other athletic practices, including paragliding, wakeboarding, sailing, and windsurfing. While predominantly known as a water sport, there are variations of kite surfing which are also adapted to land and snow. The activity involves the use of a power kite, usually consisting of a leading edge with inflatable bladders, which rises about 66 feet from the surface. It's attached via lines to a control bar and a harness. The rider uses the power of the wind for traction and typically rides on a bi-directional board, similar to a wakeboard. Kite surfing is among the most convenient and least expensive of water sports. It's also often regarded as being the fastest of water sports that don't rely on motorized assistance. The combination of high speed and unpredictable wind currents adds an ever-present element of danger to kite surfing. A number of accidents have been recorded in the past decades, some of which have had fatal outcomes. Number 7. Accident at Ocean Beach. In September of 2015, a kite surfer was left in critical condition in San Francisco after a strong gust of wind carried him from Ocean Beach and onto a nearby highway. The unidentified man and his girlfriend were setting up his rig when the wind, estimated at 50 miles per hour, swept him away. It's believed that he didn't manage to engage the quick release in time. He was dragged across a parking lot and into the Great Highway, where the kite surfer was struck by an oncoming car. The man was taken to San Francisco General Hospital with life-threatening injuries. Number 6. Logan Gemin. In January of 2019, a New Zealand physical education teacher was killed in a kite surfing accident at Tauranga's Ferguson National Park. According to eyewitnesses, 37-year-old Logan Gemin was setting up his kite with the help of a friend. Gemin was given the go-ahead and the launch went well, but a surprising gust of wind changed the kite's position. Gemin lost control and fell to the ground, still holding onto the kite. He was dragged into a wooden pole at nearly 20 miles per hour, and the high energy impact caused a fatal aortic rupture. A kite surfing expert argued that there wasn't enough space between Gemin and the edge of the road for him to properly react to losing control. He was downwind from a grass area with less than 80 feet of clear space. Gemin's reflex was to try and regain his position instead of triggering the rig's quick release. In September of that year, Tauranga Boys College renamed their hockey turf in honor of their beloved teacher's memory. Kite surfing is practiced by over 1.5 million people all over the world. Some of the most popular locations are coastal spots in Brazil, Spain, Egypt, Sri Lanka, and the Philippines. Competitive formats include racing, freestyle, and wave riding. At the Rio Olympics in 2016, the coastal racing variant of kite surfing was announced as a sport, replacing windsurfing. Conceptually, the activity can be traced back to Dutch inventor Gijsbertus Adrianus Panhuis in 1977, with designs being further developed in the 1980s and 1990s. Kite surfing was popularized by surfers in Hawaii, particularly big wave legend Laird Hamilton, and gained a wider number of practitioners by the turn of the century. For some time, kite surfing held the speed sailing world record at 55.65 knots, or about 65 miles per hour, which is faster than a swordfish swimming at top speed. The highest kite surfing jump is an estimated 111 feet, which is more than a 10-story building. Some of the most notable kite surfing crosses include the Bering Strait, from Alaska to easternmost Russia, and a transatlantic trip from the Canary Islands to the Turks and Caicos Islands. Another remarkable feat is that of Lewis Tapper, who kite surfed for over 24 days without a support crew between Salvador and San Luis, Brazil. Number 5. Matthew Wing. In January of 2019, kite surfer Matthew Wing missed his destination at Coronation Beach off the west coast of Australia and ended up stranded for the night. A malfunction of his kite led to the man being dragged for about 30 miles past his intended stopping point. When Wing failed to arrive, his friends raised the alarm with local authorities and a large rescue operation was swiftly mounted. After missing the mark, the 48-year-old eventually regained control of his kite and made land just shy of Horrocks Beach. That night, he tried to walk up the highway, but jagged cliffs and limited visibility made it extremely difficult. Wing spent the night in the dunes, half buried in sand, to avoid hypothermia. The next morning, he started walking north along the beach and was found by rescuers. Number 4. Julian Pope. In March of 2015, kitesurfing novice Julian Pope was setting up his rig when a sudden wind swept him off his feet. According to eyewitnesses, the 28-year-old was at no point in the water, but merely getting used to the kite while on the beach. After he got lofted, the man was slammed into the concrete footpath as his kite got caught in one of the pine trees on Norfolk Island. Pope suffered critical head and chest injuries that prompted emergency services to rush him to the Royal Brisbane and Women's Hospital. Unfortunately, Pope wouldn't recover from the extensive damage that he sustained in the accident. Between 2000 and 2003, there were over 100 kitesurfing accidents and at least 14 fatalities, according to a study by the Kiteboarding Safety Information Database. The power kite can take the rider to dangerous heights, and losing control can have severe consequences. After being lofted, they may be carried off, dragged, blown downwind, or dashed, which can result in them colliding with natural terrain, buildings, or power lines. Accidents may occur if the kite is caught by a strong gust of wind, but also if the rider mismanages the timing and distance of their jumps. With enough height and speed, even hitting the water at an awkward angle may yield a fatal outcome. In the sport, a severe accident is often referred to as a kite-mere. Kite surfing may also take practitioners far from shore, making it difficult for them to return by swimming. In the event of an emergency, this leaves them vulnerable to getting caught in a current or drowning, or to potentially deadly encounters with dangerous marine wildlife like sharks or poisonous jellyfish. Number 3. Adrien Monnayeur. While kite surfing off the coast of southwest France, 28-year-old Adrien Monnayeur suffered a horrific accident. Even though the weather forecasts had warned of high winds, there were a number of riders on the water. Monnayeur was caught in powerful gusts, which lifted him high into the air and carried him inland at roughly 100 miles per hour. He struck a pier and then clipped the top of a hotel. Monnayeur was then swept into the chimney stack of a 7-story boarding house and struck an additional building before he became detached from the harness and plummeted 50 feet to his death. Today's topic was inspired by Yukodol 19. If you have any other topics you'd like to learn about, subscribe and let us know in the comments section below. Number 2. Kevin Chunasingh. Kevin Chunasingh and his wife arrived in Dorset, England in 2009 for several weeks of kayaking, cycling and kitesurfing. One day during their stay, Chunasingh, who was an experienced kitesurfer, took to the beach to hone his skills. He had everything under control until a gust of wind dragged him out of the water. Chunasingh lost control of his kite and crashed head first into a parked car. The impact fractured his neck. Chunasingh survived but was left paralyzed from the chest down, and in the years that followed, lost 95% of his upper body strength. In spite of his limited mobility, Chunasingh would find his second wind as an artist and become a notable painter. Even though kitesurfing can be dangerous, there are a number of measures to be taken which increase safety and mitigate the risks. Choose a kite design that comes with advanced quick-release mechanisms and a control bar that enables you to fully depower. Wear an impact vest, as it also doubles as an improved flotation device. It protects the body but also helps in deep water self-rescue procedures, which almost all riders encounter at some point. Wear a brightly colored helmet, a wetsuit if the temperature demands it, and carry a hook knife to deal with tangled lines. Always check the weather forecast and avoid kitesurfing near storm fronts, as the winds tend to be strong and unpredictable. Exercise prudence and adapt your riding style to your experience level, instead of trying to emulate more skillful riders. Keep proper distance from others in the water and avoid jumping in the shallows or too close to elements in the environment. Number 1. Gur Finelli. In the fall of 2020, as Storm Aidan battered the coast of Ireland, a kite surfer was killed in what was described as a failed jump attempt. 39-year-old Gur Finelli was taking part in a charity event for Mental Health Ireland at Dublin's Dollymount Strand. Finelli was a triathlete with over 14 years of experience in kitesurfing. Unfortunately, the powerful wind created difficult rough riding conditions, and he lost control of the kite during a jump. This reportedly caused a high-speed impact with the water's surface. Rescue services arrived to the scene and recovered him from the water. In spite of their resuscitation attempts, Finelli was pronounced dead. Thanks for watching. Would you rather go kitesurfing in stormy weather or live in an igloo for a week? Let us know in the comments section below.